Hi, it's Kendra. One of my favorite things to paint is snow. And recently I did a painting of some skiers hiking, and a lot of people were asking me, how do you paint the footsteps in the snow? So I want to show you that right now. Basically, you just paint a little shadow and then soften it out with water at the top. It's a very simple process, but takes a little bit of practice to get an even gradient and to get it to wash away into nothing. I'm going to use this painting that I've already done the background for. I was doing a commission and I painted three backgrounds and then chose my favorite one to complete the commission. So I have this background and it needs a purpose. So let's add a skier and some footsteps. I'm just going to need my towel, paintbrush, this is the number 6 round, and some water. And I'm just going to paint the silhouette of my skier. Oh, I lied. I'm actually going to use my rigger as well. To paint a dip in snow, you need lots of paint on your brush. If you just dab, dab, dab at the edge of your palette, your paintbrush is going to be too dry and you're not going to be able to get that gradient. You're not going to be able to get the paint to move. So you need to make sure that you have lots of paint on your brush. Okay. And then you're going to paint a little dip. I'm going to just go right by the foot here. And then you dip your brush in your water, dab it off in your towel, and you just go above where you just painted, ever so softly and slowly, and then dip and dab. I call this the dip and dab method. And you overlap your last paint stroke that you just did above it. So you dip and dab and you just overlap above it. You're erasing it actually. And then finally you can clean your brush, dab off the extra water, and then erase the top into nothing. And try not to touch the legs because they'll bleed into this. Beautiful. Okay, so now I'll just do the same over here. So I paint a little dip. If you don't have much room, you can wash off your brush right away and dab it off. And then you just overlap your last brush stroke, dip and dab, and overlap it so that it erases it, the top of it. So I paint a little dip. I have to make sure it's nice and wet. Dip, dab, just go over the top of it. Dip, dab again, go over the top of that. Clean my brush, dab it off, and just erase the top. I'm just overlapping and I'm just moving slowly so that my paintbrush picks up the pigment and moves it along with the paintbrush. If I go too quickly, then it'll just skip over the roughness of the paper and it'll be more like dry brushing. And I'll get texture and it will look dry. So I want it to flow into the water. The reason I'm using my towel though is if I just dipped water and then put it into my paintbrush, it's all gonna whoosh back into that dip that I just painted and fill it with water and it's gonna have a background and then I'll get a hard, cauliflower-ish outline that's quite dark at the bottom of the dip, which I don't want. I just want it to be a soft, smooth gradient out to nothing. So let's try that again. It's worthwhile practicing this on some scrap paper or the back of an old painting until you get the hang of it. So I'm just gonna paint a little dip, dip, dab, overlap just the top of it, dip, dab, overlap the top of that, dip, dab, and then overlap the top of that again. See how it just disappears into nothing? Isn't that great? And you want to keep going until it disappears. If you just paint one or two strokes above your dip because you think it looks fine, you have to consider the drying time. So as it's drying, the paint is going to continue moving upwards and then it'll settle into that area where the wet meets dry and you'll get a hard line. So I really like to keep going until it's absolutely invisible. And then that way, even if the paint keeps traveling up as it dries, it has nowhere to end. It just fades away. Once I put down my first little bit of paint, I swish out my brush, dab it on my towel, and I'm just softening it out towards the sides here. And I'm dabbing my paintbrush on my towel each time to make sure that I don't let any paint or water into my painting. So I paint a little scoop, I rinse off my brush, dab it off on my towel, and then I just overlap my last brush stroke above it. And it just fades it out into a gradient. And if it needs any more, you can clean your brush, dab it off, and then you can erase any extra edges that are there. It's important that each time you paint one of these dips, that you keep on dipping and dabbing with your brush until you completely erase the top. See, if I stopped right now, I would get a hard line at the top. So I need to keep going and pull this up and clean my brush, dab it off, and then just finally do that final sweep to erase the top. And then here I'm just erasing the side of one with some clear water. And I just keep on going. Really important to use that towel to help avoid too much water on your brush. I hope you enjoyed this lesson on footprints in snow and that you'll have fun practicing this on your own. Good luck.